Hello, this is Dr. Gay from First Look MRI, and this is a patient who has a tear of their left hip labrum, and the tear is in the posterior labrum, not a place we see tears commonly. Usually the tear is in the superior hip labrum. So on this view, we see the femoral head, which is round. We see the acetabulum, this cup, where it sits and rotates, and around the rim of the cup, there's a little black wedge here. That little black wedge is the labrum, and the superior hip labrum is right out here on this outer side. The anterior hip labrum is in front, wraps around over here, and the posterior hip labrum is in back right here. And that linear band is the labral tear, that little white line. But again, the superior hip labrum, where we normally see a tear, is fine. Now we're going to look for the posterior hip labrum, not in the coronal view, but on the sagittal and axial view. So if we put up an axial view, we're going to look back here. This is the posterior acetabulum, and there it is. There's a little area of fluid that goes into the tear right there. You can see the labrum right there and a little fluid going into it. And now we did some thin 3D T2 weighted sequences through the hip. We'll look at those. This is a sagittal view. This is the anterior hip labrum over here in front. We really can't see the superior hip labrum on this view. We can see the anterior and posterior, but right here, this little area of fluid signal, that is the tear of the posterior hip labrum. You see it looks like a little curved linear band of fluid. So a tear of the posterior hip labrum. Again, these are thin 1 millimeter images. Now we're going to put up 3 millimeters. We have the 3 millimeter reconstructed images, and it's not very well seen on those. So here we go, 3 millimeters, and you just don't really notice this right here, but you really wouldn't be able to say for sure without those thin images that it was there. So these thin images do seem to be pretty important. This is the posterior acetabulum again. We're going to find the tear. There it is right there, a little bit of fluid going into the posterior labral tear. So not that common, super easy to miss unless you had thin images and you're really looking carefully for it. And that's it. Thank you very much.